Boy, tough times for the Nats in that National Party caucus at the moment, following the release of the latest Reed Research poll earlier this week. With Simon Bridges and Paula Bennett now facing a leadership challenge from Todd Muller and Nikki Kaye tomorrow at midday. And the poll results weren't exactly pleasant for New Zealand First either, with a level of support that would see them out on their ears unless they won an electorate at the next election or got back beyond 5%. Joining us now to discuss that and possibly more if we have the time are our regulars, who are Paula Bennett and Shane Jones. We're delighted to have you with us. Thank you both for joining us. Paula Bennett, I'm really grateful for you joining us this morning. I thought you might not, so I'm thrilled you're here. Can I start with you? Look, can you take us inside the process? How have you spent the last 24 hours? Are you working the phones? Are you talking to caucus? Are you doing the numbers?
First of all, John, I'm never a no-show, you know? So here we are out in the cold and having an opportunity to talk to you and Shane. So that's always a bit of fun on a weekly basis. Look, it definitely is interesting times, but gosh, I've just been watching your show and you're hearing of thousands of New Zealanders losing their jobs and more to come. And that's pretty sobering. And I think it gets this National Party caucus pretty focused on what we should be talking about, which is actually helping this country and having that debate. So, I mean, I'm not surprised at the polls. I mean, we've just had the 7 or 8 weeks that have been pretty extraordinary and a Prime Minister that stepped up and got us through a real health crisis. But as we move into an economic one, it looks a bit different. So, look, yep, I'm definitely talking to my caucus, definitely sort of talking to them about what happens, but we'll just sort that out behind a closed door in ourselves.
Absolutely. Can you give us a sense of the numbers, though? Do you have the numbers? Do you and Simon Bridges have the numbers?
Look, it's just so inappropriate to sort of for me to sort of go down that path when really, as I say, that's a matter for our caucus and we do that with each other. But look, I'm feeling really confident. You know, as I say, I want to get back to talking about how we get this country back up and running, how we sort of get jobs.
Absolutely.
You know, that's what's important.
Yeah. You know, it was funny. I've been listening to Simon Ridges say, and lots of Nats say, Michelle Bogue and various tribal national people saying, gosh, you know, the Prime Minister's had so much exposure that it's no wonder that she's doing so well. The Nats were calling her part-time PM, you know, this time last year. And I just wonder, did you underestimate her? And did Simon Bridges and the attack politics he brought to bear over the lockdown period miscalculate the mood of the country? Did you fail to read the room?
I don't think so. I mean, gosh, 4 months ago, the polls were saying that actually National would lead the next government. And in 4 months' time, we plan on that happening again. But look, the Prime Minister stepped up in an extraordinary time. And as I say, I think during that health crisis, we listened to her as a country and we got there. We're just now going into very different times. But look, as I say, 4 months ago, we were, you know, we would have been governing at that point. And as I say, we've got a job to do in the next 4 months.
I just want to, I'm coming to you in a sec, Shane Jones, because it's very rude to have a guest and just ignore them, so I apologise. But Paula, can I just ask you, this is fascinating to me. You are National's campaign chair. And if I look at the release that Peter Goodfellow put out in August of last year, it says, Paula is an incredible campaigner with over a decade of political experience. And people are really talking up your ability to campaign. So obviously that will be being applied now on behalf of you and Simon Bridges to retain your positions as leader and deputy leader. But can you remain campaign chair of the National Party if you're campaigning for a guy who's just shafted you?
Oh, look, the caucus will work their way through it with the party and that's what we'll do, and we'll put the best people forward at the end of the day, and I'm really confident of the team that we've got. I've got hopefully a particular set of skills that I think can certainly help National in the best light and help this country, more importantly, to get back on track economically and see that as a future. But I've got a lot of confidence in my caucus colleagues,
right,
actually, that at the end of the day we'll pull together and we'll go in the same direction.
So will you stay campaign chair for National if Todd Muller and Nikki Kaye are leader and deputy leader? Can you do so in good faith?
Oh, look, that's something for our caucus to discuss, as okay. I say, and I don't think it's sort of for me to be sitting here trying to decide what jobs might be. You know, we've got an interesting kind of 36 hours ahead of us, and I wish we weren't doing it, because I think there's more important things we should be doing. But here we are. We'll get through that by Friday afternoon. We'll be back on track, heading it out there, and I know we'll be doing it as a team.
Will you still be deputy leader by Friday afternoon?
That's my plan. And I'm feeling good and I'm feeling confident. And I think that, you know, we've got a message to get out there and get on track and just keep doing what we're doing because, yeah, the country needs us. And we need a contest. We need a contest of ideas in the next 4 months.
Yeah.
And I think that's really important that this election does, you know, get a bit of New Zealand First, bit of Greens in there, putting their ideas forward. And we go out there and we really talk about the stuff that matters.
You threw beautifully to Shane Jones. And so let's bring him in. New Zealand First in the Read Research poll at 2.7%. We should say we have a Colmar Brunton here on TV1 tonight at 6 o'clock, and that will be absolutely fascinating and may determine the outcome of Nationals caucus decision one way or another. But Shane Jones, 2.7%, you are only halfway to the 5% threshold. What does New Zealand First have to do to guarantee that any of you return to Parliament?
Well, historically, New Zealand First has never polled all that well during the actual cycle of the three-year governing period, but we always stand up and go well over the 5% at the time of voting. But look, it's an extraordinary time, John. You've said it better than I can. There's been wall-to-wall coverage as New Zealanders have collectively stood together. The Prime Minister has created a great sense of reassurance. It's not surprising that there's a poll dividend. But one thing I'll agree with Paula, the economic contagion, I suspect, is going to be equally as challenging. And our caucus is just never going to agree with fanciful ideas such as giving people more holidays. So if we don't get the economy turned around, we'll all be on a permanent holiday.
I want to talk about how New Zealand First campaigns. And Shane, I just want to put this on the table. You campaign best as an opposition party. You campaign best as an outsider, as the party that speaks truth to power, as the mavericks, as the, you know, the draining the swamp, to use that awful Trump phrase. Are you going to find it difficult to campaign as a constructive member of a coalition government? Are you going to look for issues to be oppositional on? And are you going to stand aside from the government and fire back into the tent that you are currently inside?
Well, New Zealand First has to go out and put its credentials amongst the people. I mean, we'll contrast the fact that at the moment, Paula and the National Party are afflicted by a split brain syndrome. So that's for them to solve. But I'll tell you what, the Kiwis are flocking to New Zealand First the more they see that level of divisiveness.
Well, Shane, they're not. I mean, I'm sorry to be rude to you because you're a guest and we value you, but 2.7% ain't flocking. I mean, that's, you know, that's about four seagulls on an empty beach, isn't it? I mean, you know, they're dreadful numbers.
Yeah, I just don't share your sense of despair. We've come out of an 8 to 10 week period where we're dealing with this extraordinary medical episode. And the reality is that New Zealand First represents an insurance policy. Sure, Simon doesn't want to be with us, but Simon may not survive as a consequence of the split brain syndrome.
Who are you picking? Who are you picking in the Nats? Is it going to be, is this, so tomorrow afternoon, is it going to be Todd Muller or Simon Bridges, who's going to be leader of the National Party?
Well, look, either of them, unfortunately, are going to be saddled with the Bill English problem of trying to fight an election with a two in front of their poll. So whoever is on the horse, unfortunately, is irrelevant because once divisiveness is currently besetting the National Party takes root, Kiwis turn away. And New Zealand First will be a dividend and will be a natural insurance to ensure that common sense and strong economic policies are brought to the fore that may not absolutely suit how Labor wants to campaign. And to suggest that we can't have a different opinion than Prime Minister Jacinda Ardern going towards an election shows a poor understanding of democracy. My views will be very different as we get closer to the election.
Paula Bennett, can we bring you in here? You started by talking about the economy, and I gently want to suggest that you were changing the subject, except that isn't the subject that we should be changing from, is it? That is so critical. As jobs are being lost, as there is a sense of the profoundly uphill battle of getting our economy back on track, what a bummer that the Nats are providing this kind of diversion from the sorts of work you should be doing. I mean, are you cross with Todd Muller and Nikki Kaye? Aren't they the distraction?
Oh, look, when you when you hear about small businesses that are just closing their doors now, you know, before they go bankrupt, and that means jobs, and when you see things happening at Air New Zealand and Fletcher's like we are, and the towns, then that is what we want to focus on, and that is what's important. Look, we are where we are. And we're a big party that is actually a family, and sometimes that family has a bit of an argument amongst itself, and then we pull ourselves back together and we get back on with it. And I've been around this party long enough, and I know that we can and will do that. So look, yep, we should. I rather we weren't where we are, but we will sort of get through the next couple of days, and then I just have every confidence we'll get on message and we'll get out there and we'll sell it.
I think you know by now whether you have the numbers. I think you know that. Do you think you've got them?
Oh, look, I'm feeling really confident standing here this morning, John.
Paula Bennett and Shane Jones, thank you. Oh, sorry, Shane Jones.
No, look, all parties...
You can't let him take the last hit.
Yeah. Well, let's see what it is.
All families and all parties go through the divisiveness, so that's their wocker to paddle, but you're not a family at the moment, Paula. Paula, you're the pockers.
Shane Jones and Paula Bennett, thank you both so much for joining us. We really appreciate it.
Thank you.
We're very grateful for your time. Thank you.